So blockchains have gone to the point where they cannot be ignored right now because they are taking the world by storm. And we have Web 1.1, Web 2.0, which we are now, and then we have Web 3.0. And blockchain, one of the problems we currently face today is that of transactions. So there's high fees, like in Ethereum, it takes too much to transact. And then we have the issues of resource. It's very resource intensive. You have to download hundreds of gigabytes, like in Bitcoin, 300 gigabytes to be able to verify the chain, or else you have to trust a third party to do that. And then there is no transaction as a result of the resource intensiveness. What I present to you today is the MENA protocol. So with the MENA protocol, we'll talk about what is this. So this is a blockchain that is succinct. So what that means is that it's never going to exceed a certain limit. It's going to be fixed 20 kilobytes. And this 20 kilobytes is basically a proof of all the history plus the maker part. So what that means is that with zero knowledge proofs, you'll be able to prove that. So this is a snapshot of the blockchain. And then we can say at point A, this is what happened. You take a snapshot of it. And then this is point two. This is what happened. So far, I'll take a picture of it. And what we just do is we keep taking picture of it. So an example, a good example to explain is this. Supposing you have a big toy, you can do two things. You can either convince your colleagues to come to your house to come and see the toy, or you could take the toy to school, which is very big, which you may not be able to do, or you can simply take a photo of that same toy and go and show your friends. So for the MENA protocol, it uses zero knowledge proofs to take a snapshot of whatever happens on the blockchain. So you take a picture, and then you take another picture of that picture, and you keep taking pictures. So what you just need to prove that this thing is actually true is having the pictures of all the blocks rather than having this. Let's talk about some of the applications that can actually happen with MENA is scalability by decentralization. So we're having a blockchain system where any single person on the planet can be able to verify the chain, because you don't have to trust a third party that has hundreds of nodes. With your mobile phone, you'll be able to check and say, okay, what is the state of this transaction? And then it also provides two sets of ZK proofs and ZK snacks. So if you want to build ZK snacks related applications, you don't need to have PhD before you can be able to build that. They are building two sets for that. And then with that, you can be able to port reward application to the blockchain. So what MENA protocol uses is ZK proofs. So ZK proofs is actually a way where we can actually prove that something is true without revealing any knowledge. So a good example could be, supposing you want to walk into a place and they said you can only get access to this place if you are above 18 or if you have certain amount of money in your account. So how do you prove that you are above 18 without actually revealing your age to the person? So you just bring your ID, you scan your ID, and then you get access to the place. Unlike before, where they will have to check your ID physically or with some system. The prover is able to verify that you are actually above 18 without diverging. And Ethereum, for example, they implemented a lot of zero knowledge proof technologies in order to scale the blockchains. Now, right now, you don't have to do a lot of computation. You just have some cryptographic proof that everything happening in the system so far has been true. So in this system, we talk about some of the types of nodes on the system. So we have archival nodes. So these are basically nodes that store all the transactions on the system. But then we have the consensus nodes. Those are involved in consensus. So let's talk about the token economics before we talk about other things. So the token economics, at the initial genesis, which is I think days or weeks away from now, it's 1 billion tokens will be minted at genesis, and then there will be 12% inflation. After 48 months, which is 4 years, it will drop to 7% inflation. And then there are supercharged rewards. So if you do not unlock your coins, you will get double the block rewards. So another thing again is in this platform is called Picos. So Picos, before now, if you want to do zero knowledge proofs, you have to have a trusted setup. or Picos, there is no need for that trusted setup. And it offers core CK snacks that anybody can use to build stuff without having PhD in cryptography. And then there is developer toolkit that implements all this, and you can use to implement all this. And then the next thing I'm talking about is the snaps. So snaps represent applications that are similar to DLS. So these are applications that have zero knowledge proof property built into it. So they're not like other applications where you can have an add-ons and to see you want to build zero knowledge proof. No, they are special applications that are special DLS that are built on the MENA protocol using this not new language. So there is I'll put a link to that. And then for consensus, or to cover consensus node, it uses staking and it uses the Ouroboros family of consensus, and it has its own improved consensus, which is called the Ouroboros Samashika. So what this means is that, so for the Ouroboros Samashika, the block producer is selected pre-epoch, and that makes it very hard to perform such an attack. And mind you, one of the things from the Gauntlet report, they estimate that it will take less than probably $100 per month to be able to be evaluated on this network. So it's very, very cheap, because you just need basic device and the rest of it. So there are three rules on the network where the verifiers. The verifiers, they actually verify everything on the network. So you can call them the full nodes, verifier of full nodes, they get rewards. While block producers get block rewards and also transaction fees, and then we have the snackers. So the snackers, what they do is that they produce snacks or historical proofs of all the transactions that have been happening in the system, and then they sell to the block producers. So for you, a transaction to be added to a block, it's required that the block producer attach a historical proof of snacks to that block. So this is a particular block at this point in time. Let's say TCP at a point in time, and then it has to attach other historical proofs, and that can be produced by snackers. So the token utility, it can be used for staking. You can stake this as to be a staker, or you can delegate your stake, and also in rewards. It's used for payments and also for incentives. So for being a staker, you get a new network. There are a lot of grants that are available that you can build a lot of things. If you want to build any kind of decentralized application, you want to use Snappy to build snaps, you want to do anything, there are plenty of grants for that, for community management, bugs, or it can also be part of the Genesis program. We can involve you in different challenges. And a MENA protocol can be a system that takes a photo of a photo of a photo. So the best scenario, like, I have a kid and the kid has a very mighty toy, and the toy is he himself can't even move the toy out of the house, right, because of their size. The kid can either take the toy to school, which is almost impossible, or invite his friends to come and see the toy, or he can just take a photo of it. So what the MENA does is makes it available that you can just take a photo of it using this ZK proofs. No longer dealing with the hassle of 300 gigabytes with the rest of the other networks. With a mobile phone, anybody can verify this stuff. And then there is plenty of application for that.